Oh, dick.
Thanks a lot for coming along with Life with BillSiff. Let's see what's really going on.
Welcome to Dirty Old BillSiff Show.
How you doing today? Welcome to Life with BillSiff. I'm your host, Frickin' BillSiff. I got the truck up, like you know. I've got the drum painted, I got the inner wheel well painted on this side, as you can see. I've got front wheel wells out, and I've got this painted up in here, as you can see. So, I'm just gonna work underneath the truck and get it all painted, but I was brushing it, and I'll tell you right now, brushing sucks dick. Or as I say, cocks. Friggin' right it does. I'm done with brushing. I ordered myself up a sprayer. And we're gonna mix the old paint up there with some acetone and we're gonna friggin' spray into the truck. That's hence the cover on the truck here. I know I'm gonna get some overspray on the truck, you're bound to, but I gotta maybe wet sand this thing and buff it anyway, so I think we'll be okay. But, I did get the other engine. The other engine's in my possession. Look at that. So this is the engine that's gonna go in there, and there's a transmission that's gonna go in there, which is a 700R Foreskins. Now this thing here is a custom went off 965 horsepower 305. Do you believe me? I might not. But it is definitely one of a kind 305, this one right here. I'll tell you that right now. So what we got here is a 305 that has a little bit of work done to it. Not much, but a little bit. We're gonna stick with old school here. We got some Rolly Rockies on it. We got all new valve, you know. The gentleman that I got it from put all new valve springs in it and keepers, as you can see. We got some roller 1.5s on her. We've got all ported and look at it. It's all port matched throughout the engine. If you could only see in life, look at the exhaust. Captain, can you see in there? Oh, you gotta see in there. Let me get a light. It's got a custom, look at that. Custom camshaft here. It's got a custom ground camshaft in this bad boy too, right from Comp Cams. So it should run off the natural stuff. But look inside there. Look how nice that is. What a nice port job. Good job, Mike. It's friggin' awesome. All in here is port match. Look at it. Look how smooth those runners are for a 305 high output head. You know, like it's just killer. Look at it. And then of course, he didn't stop there, boys. He went right from exhaust, intake, right to the friggin' throttle body. So here's the actual intake, which is all port matched. As you can see, hey, it's got a little cross over there. Even the throttle body, look at it, port matched to the throttle body. So when it goes on, it's all port matched. All port matched, look at the runners. Look at them. Can you see that? Are you seeing what I'm looking at? Look at it. Friggin' right. So this 305, it should work pretty friggin' good. It should work really good, actually. So I'm excited to try it. Leave a comment down below if you're excited to see it. I'm sure you are. Tape's been on there a while. Might have to put some new tape back on it now. But it's safe where it is. Nothing's gonna get dropped in there. He's even got tape on the spark plug holes. That's how important this thing is. So it's gonna be friggin' decent. She's no LS, Jim. Everybody's doing LS now. So I figure, you know what? I was gonna do an LS, but I'm gonna stay old school with this one. This is a fuel injected truck because it's an 87. So we're going with throttle body fuel injection and it should be pretty unique. But yeah, look at that, eh? Look at the inner fender well. She looks mint, Captain. I'll paint it up in there. Paint it up back here. I just gotta get under there and do all that. Frig. She's a lot of work. See, I started under here. But I didn't, you know, get very far because I was brushing it and I got sick of it. And then, of course, I started here. And, of course, this is a real pain in the ass to brush. I don't know if you ever tried brushing that. And, of course, you know, I got all this brushed and stuff. But, you know, she's going to be friggin' gold when I'm done. And then this thing come out. Hey, look, it's got the factory friggin' headers like I told you before on it. And then we got the extra small exhaust all the way to the back. I'm going to have to make a little bigger exhaust, let her breathe a little better. Leave your comments down below if you think I should do that. I would. But I just wanted to give you a little update video on that because the 700R4 is all built, ready to go. It's got a shift kit in it, got an extra band in it. I know I'm forgetting to tell you, he's got Molly rods on there, or Molly pistons and Molly pistons? He's got good bearings in it. Anyways, it's a good motor. I can't remember everything because I'm trying to tell you and I'm just cocked over and it's got everything. Look at the metal finish on this thing. Remember these old valve covers? Morosos? These used to be Morosos. Look at, He metal finished a Miyoso right out of her. So all we can do is paint them up, weld in a little windage tray there, so we don't get any back feed. And we'll be mint there, got my little stall converter. Should stall at about 900 RPM inches. Get a gasket kit. Frig, leave your comments down below if you want to come over and put this in for me. I'm joking, leave your comments down below if you want to come help me put it in. I'd be all right. I need about 10 guys, and we'd have her done in about 20 minutes. Look at that, look at the shine. Hey, look at it. What a nice paint color. That's what they call Toyota Blue. Nice job. Well, just so you know, it's got a new gas tank, as you can see. And Mike also shortened the frame 1 inch to bring this gap in tighter. Because the square body's always had a huge gap here. This one here, 1 inch brought in, so the box fits tighter to the cab. All the body lines are mint. Look at the body lines on this thing. Hey, he's even shaved, took off the drip rails. But this thing's straight, man. This guy, I'll tell you what, right now, put a lot of time into this truck. She is friggin' straight. She's a beaut. Can't wait to drive it. Leave your comments down below if you can't wait to see me drive it. Leave your comments down below and let me know what you think of the three. It's actually a 315, but it is a 305 60 over, so that's what it is. I'm pretty sure Mike built the only 315 in Sarnia. I'm pretty sure it's the only 305 board 60 over around. Quite a big area, so we're gonna have to see. She'll be a revver. The old 305 is a little short stroke. They like to rev, they do. So she should take about 65 hundo at least. But anyways, this is just a little video on what's going on over here. I gotta go downstairs and make a t-shirt for Josh there and support Stanley. And you ordered up a t-shirt today. How you doing, bud? Hey, thanks for supporting me. Why wouldn't you? But I'm gonna go downstairs, make that. Hope everyone's having a good day. Let me know what you think of this truck so far. Let me know if you want to see more content on there. I am kind of just about ready for bed because, yeah, I've been rolling around down under there for a bit. I'm kind of not into doing any more of that right now. But I got it vacuumed up under there, a little bit cleaned up. So next is spray. Hopefully everyone's having a good day like me. Hopefully you enjoy these videos. I try my best for you. Hopefully you can understand that. Love y'all. And until next time, you know what to do for now.